Coverage you can count on continues with Glenn Marini's Sports Report.
Few teams in the state have the history that Bishop Dwenger football does. In fact, after winning this past Friday night, the Saints now have 18 regional titles in program history, tops among all schools in Indiana. It's one of the many reasons we honor the Saints as the Orthopedic Hospital of Lutheran Health Network Team of the Week.
The Orthopedic Hospital at Lutheran Health, teaming up with Fort Wayne Orthopedics, is proud to present this week's Team of the Week. Congratulations.
There it is, the Spirit Tree chant at the end of every Bishop Dwenger practice. 40 years of tradition here at Bishop Dwenger, and they are the Team of the Week. I want to talk to the captains right now, Mike Theocable, Ryan Watercutter, and Nathan Neese. They're right here, and Mike, you guys are playing ECC, East Chicago Central, for a regional championship or for a semi-state championship this week. Talk about what you're going to have to do to be successful this coming Friday at Zollner.
Yep, I mean, we're just going to prepare like how we normally prepare, week in and week out. We just got to execute our assignments, everyone doing their job, and we'll come out on top if we do that.
What is this team doing really well at this point to get this far in the season?
We're all bonding together well, not just on the field, but off the field also in the locker room. We're all becoming brothers and family, and that's a big key to our success lately.
All right, I'm going down the line to Nathan, just talk a little bit about the defensive unit, because it's been impressive. People see the offensive numbers in the paper, but the defensive numbers have been fantastic for this team, especially in the postseason. You've only given up 30 points in four games.
Yeah, I mean, Dwenger has prided themselves on good defense, you know, keeping Cannon, these great running backs, another challenge this week.
As far as ECC goes, what do you know about them? Because they seem like an opportunistic offense. They can make the big play. What do they do well that you're going to have to counter this coming Friday?
I mean, they got a lot of seniors, a lot of great players on their team. And, you know, they can't make those big plays because they have those seniors on their team.
A final question for you. What are you most looking forward to about this game coming up on Friday at 7:30?
I want to see these big guys. I heard they're pretty big.
Well, you guys are pretty big, too. Ryan Watercutter joining me now. And Ryan, you've seen this team from day one. Where have you guys made the biggest strides to get to this point in the season?
You know, definitely our defense side of the ball. You know, we came up in postseason, you know, giving up 30 points total. That's definitely a huge accomplishment for our defense. They're bringing it hard every week and, you know, improving every week.
When you take a look at your schedule, one of the toughest in the state, you go to Cincinnati LaSalle, you win, you play Cathedral at home. That's a tough ball game. But how have those games prepared you for a run in the postseason?
You know, facing all these 6A schools and, you know, LaSalle definitely prepares you for the postseason. You know, you see it all and you know what to expect.
Final question, what's going to be the biggest key Friday night for these Saints?
You know, they got a lot of athletes. We need to contain them, and if we do that, we should be on top. And I'm just looking forward to, you know, representing Fort Wayne and Dwenger and the semi-state game and hopefully the state championship. So we'll see what happens.
All right. Good luck to the Bishop Dwenger Saints. They are playing for semi-state this Friday at Zollner Stadium, and they are a very deserving Team of the Week. Congratulations, guys.
Thank you.
Yeah, normally we work the coach into the Team of the Week segment, but coach is not allowed over at the Spirit Tree after practice. So, you know, if you have a tradition like that and you win as much as they do, just keep doing what you're doing. It seems to make sense.
Yeah, superstitious works sometimes,
absolutely.
Right? Thanks, Glenn.
Up next, Nicholas has a last look at the forecast.